Okay, hello and good day everyone. No? So today we will discuss about the volume of circular figures, no? So pag sinabi kong circular figures, this involves the cylinder, cone at saka yung sphere. Now, here, first example natin is about cylinder, no? So cylinder, no, to find the volume, no, we need the height, no, of the figure at saka yung radius ng base. Okay? So yung radius ng base here is 4 decimeter. Well, yung height is 12 decimeter. Okay? Now, to find the volume, no, we will use this formula. Now, we have V is equal to pi r squared h. No? Okay. So, yung pi natin here is equal to 3.14 times yung r is 4 decimeter. No? So, 4 decimeter square times yung h natin is 12 decimeter. Now, multiply 3.14 times 4. Ay, no, no, no. Ito muna. Kasi may exponent na to eh. No? Ito muna yung gitna. Yung radius muna. 4 decimeter square is equal to 16 square decimeter. Because 4 times 4 is 16. No? Yan ang meaning ng 4 squared eh. 4 times 4 is 16. Then, multiply natin itong tatlo. 3.14 times 16 times 12, that would be equal to 602.88 cubic decimeter. Again, volume yan. Okay? Kaya may 3 na exponent yung unit. Okay? So that is for cylinder, no? Paki-memorize itong formula, no? Next, cone naman, no? So cone naman, ganun din. Kailangan din ng height tsaka ng radius, no? Yung radius niya dito is 6 cm, yung height is 9 cm. Now, to find the volume, okay, ang difference dito kasi nag-divide tayo by 3. Bakit may division? O bakit tayo nag-divide ng 3? So you can see kasi yung cone, no, nakakapag-form siya ng parang triangle, no, yung appearance niya. Every solid figure na may appearance of a triangle, no, except for the triangular prism, kasi triangular prism yung base is triangle. Dito naman, mismo yung appearance mismo ng figure, no, nagiging triangle. That's why we always divide it by 3. Just like in pyramid, tsaka, yes, no? Triangular pyramid tsaka square pyramid. Now, yung pi here is 3.414 times yung r natin is 6 squared. Yung height natin is 9 centimeter divided by 3. Okay? Now, unahin natin to. 6 centimeter square is equal to, or 6 squared is equal to 36 square centimeter. Then multiply natin itong tatlo. No, 3.14 times 36 times 9, that would be equal to, you can use calculator here para di magkamali. We have 1,017.36 cubic centimeter divided by 3. Then we have 339.12 cubic centimeter. So that is for the volume. Okay? Next, sa sphere naman tayo. No? Okay, so sphere, as you can see, kailangan lang natin ng radius. Okay? So, yung radius natin dito, 6 decimeter. Okay? Now, what is the volume? The formula, we have 4 times pi times r cube over by 3. No, bakit tayo nag-multiplied by 4 dito? Kasi dito, itong sphere na to, no, it is divided into 4 quadrants. No, nani-divide siya into 4 quadrants. That's why we have 4 here. Then divided by 3 ulit. No? Even though kahit na walang triangular na form, we still need to divide it by 3, no? Because involved dito yung mismong ano, yung pinaka tawag nito. Kasi nakakapag-form din to ng triangle eh, no? Involved yung triangle, why? Paano ko ba? Wait. Gawa ko ng example, no? Sphere. Ito na lang. Yes, ito. And then, wala kasi akong line. Ay, ganyan na lang. Broken lines dapat eh. Okay? Try natin to ha. Sir, kapag ka nag-create tayo ng four regions here, no? As you can see here, yan. So itong part na to, no, yan, nakakapag-form tayo ng triangle dyan. Okay, that's why kaya we still need to divide it by 3. Sabi ko kanina, kapag involved yung triangle na appearance, may division ng 3 yun. Okay? Now, balik tayo dito. Okay, so ito yung formula na 4 times pi times r cube divide by 3. Now, substitute natin, yung pi natin is 3.14, yung r natin is 6 decimeter, then divide it by 3. No? Now, i-simplify muna natin to. 6 decimeter cube, ayun na na. 4 times 3.14, we have 12.56. Then, 6 cube, so 6, I mean 3 times natin mamultiply yung 6 by itself, 6 times 6 times 6, that would be equal to 216 cubic decimeter. Then multiply 12.56 times 216, that is equal to 2,712.96 cubic decimeter divided by 3. No? Divide by 3, that would be equal to 904.32 cubic decimeter for the volume. Okay? Next word problem tayo, no? What is the radius of the cylinder if its volume is 324.8 cubic meters, no? And its height, no, if ever nyo lang din nakikita kasi nga may ano na picture, ay, and its height is 5.2 meters. So this time naman, no, given na yung volume ng cylinder and then yung height niya. Na yung volume niya is 324.8 cubic meters, yung height is 5.2 meters. Okay? What is the radius of the cylinder? Kaya hanapin natin yung radius. To find it, again, we will use this formula. No? Substitute your V2, 324.8 cubic meters. No? Your pi to 3.14. Yung radius natin is unknown. Yung height natin is 5.2. Okay? Multiply 3.14 times 5.2. That would be equal to 16.328 meters r squared. Or, yes, r squared. No? And then divide both sides by 16.328 meters na para maging r squared lang ang matira dito kasi ito yung hinahanap natin. I cancel out to. No? 324.8 divided by 16.328. I using calculator kasi nga maraming decimal places. Then, that would be equal to 19.89 square meters. Okay? Di pa dyan nagtatapos. R squared pa to. Dapat r lang yan. Walang exponent na 2. Kung may exponent na 2, no, para matanggal, kunin natin yung square root of both sides. Square root of 19.89 square meters, that is equal to 4.46 meters. Square root of r squared, or simply cancel out yung square root symbol tsaka yung 2, that is r. So the radius is 4.46 meters. Okay? Next. What is the height of the cone if its volume is 452 cubic meters and its radius is 4 meters? Okay? Sa cone naman, no? Given yung volume, which is 452 cubic meters, and its radius is 4 meters, ano da yung height? Again, using this formula, no? Substitute your pi to 3.4, I mean yung V muna, for 452 cubic meters, your pi to 3.14, yung R natin is 4 meters square, times h, kasi unknown pa yung height, over by 3. Okay? And then, 4 squared is equal to 16, no? Then multiply 3.14 times 16. Ay, no, no, no. 452, tama, tama. Equal to 3.14 times 16, that is equal to 50.24 square meters over by 3. Then, itong 3, multiply natin dito. No? 452 cubic meters times 3 equal to 50.24 square meters height. No? Multiply 452 times 3 that would be equal to 1,356. And then divide voltage by 50.24 square meters. Yan, divide natin para H na lang matira dito. Okay? And then here, 1,356 divided by 50.24, that would be equal to 26.99 meters. Cancel this out, ang natira dito, H na lang. No? Which is the height of the cone. Okay, next, number three. The volume of the sphere is 52.72 cubic decimeter. What is the radius? Okay, this time given yung volume and the radius. Using this formula, no, here, substitute your V to 52.72 cubic decimeter equal to 4 times yung pi natin is 3.14. R natin unknown pa, kaya R cube pa rin yan, over by 3. Okay, multiply 4 times 3.14. Okay, ito muna pala, no? 52.72 times 3, kasi itong 3 galing yan dito sa denominator. At then 4 times 3.14, that is equal to 12.56 R cube, no? Then multiply 52.72 times 3, that would be equal to 158.16 cubic decimeter. Then divide voltage by 12.56, no? 158.16 divided by 12.56, that would be equal to 12.59 cubic decimeter. I cancel this out, natira R cube. Hindi pa dyan nagtatapos. May exponent pang 3 yung R, dapat single R lang yan, walang exponent na nakalagay. No? To remove yung exponent na 3 dito, just get the cube root of which sides. No? Cube root ng 12.59 cubic decimeter at saka yung cube root ng R cube. Okay? Again, think of a number na if you multiply that number 3 times by itself, the product is 12.59. So, ano yun? That is 2.33 decimeter. No? Cancel this out, then we have R. Okay? So, yun ang radius natin. 2.33 decimeter. Okay? That's it. Thank you for listening, and again, do not forget to answer your exercises. Your quiz and assignment to be followed na. Okay? That's all. Goodbye and God bless.